language team, and they want to do Kalamazoo versus Rockford Peaches throwback jersey night, because Kalamazoo had a team in the league, and they wanted information from us. So by what we've done at Meyer Stadium, it's expanding out into, you know, now into the minor league part of baseball, which is really good, because that's just going to help us build what we want to do at Meyer Stadium. Now, another one on your question was the International Women's Baseball Center. The county is working very close with them on tax breaks and securing grants and loans for them.
You would think that eventually, they're never going to be first, they're going to see what happens.
Well, one of the benefits that we have is right down the street is another semi-professional baseball field called Marinelli Field. And a gentleman took that over last year, and he's been working his rear end off trying to get that back up and running for youth baseball. We get to use that for our tournament. And that's a historic part too, because we did have a lot of teams there that have major league affiliations.
One of the things though about Rockford, if you haven't been in Rockford lately, there's a lot of movement to bring the center, the town center, city center of Rockford back to life. And part of that is a $65 million indoor sports complex along the Rock River, south of East State Street. That's only a little over a mile in distance road-wise from White Park. So with the development that's taking place, the sports emphasis in Rock River, our district just also completed a 20-some million dollar sports court 2 project out on the northeast side of town that includes six baseball fields that are all synthetic turf and can be used for fast pitch softball, slow pitch softball, and baseball with major league dimensions, because they all have their gentleman's question about Kenosha and Rockford, okay, and Simmons Field. Hopefully in June, our team, along with the Chicago Gems team of women's baseball, will be hosting on a weekend in June a women's baseball clinic and tournament that will involve Simmons Field and Carthage College.
Oh,
okay. That is the plan. It's not chiseled in stone. But what we're hoping to do is get more women involved in baseball through this clinic and then splitting them up into teams and playing this way. So the affiliation with the Rockford Northwoods League team and the Kenosha team will come into play on this.
Glad to hear.
Two questions. What year did the original Meyer Stadium get torn down? And then they got the ballpark out on the tollway that was all this office.
No, it's
Bank.
And the Northwoods League has a 5-year lease.
Is that what's going on there?
And that's right next door to the sports court too that he just talked about.
So the Frontier League is on
then?
Yeah.
Where that stadium is called Aviator Stadium, is just to the north, in the northwest corner of this new Park District complex. The Park District will eventually own that stadium.
Okay.
Right now, the Northwoods team that's in there has a 5-year lease with the bank on it, okay? Park District already owns half of the parking lot there. So eventually that will become the Park District's tournament facility for baseball. And they will allow the team to be there, but they'll also use it for tournaments that would they attract tournament teams to play tournaments.
And what year was the original Meyer Park?
94 or 95. Okay. And just left us 3 acres of grass.
I think it'd be a great idea if you could have this video going as an ongoing video in your museum area. It would be very informational to show the history. And secondly, maybe somebody knows Tom Hanks or Lee Marshall, and they could build us
Well,
that'd be
that's where the money is.
Last year, I went into Chicago and I met nine of the girls that were in the movie, and I've been in close contact with Ann Kuzak, who played Shirley Baker in the movie. In 2 years, it'll be their 25th anniversary, and I am desperately pulling out hairs trying to convince Penny Marshall that they should have their 25th anniversary at the original Peach and Blossom movie. I've been working on that for about a year. But
how about the Benjamin?
It always takes that to get them, you know. So we'll see what happens there.
But you're doing a lot for the community and trying to play the philanthropic angle to her is your strong pitch, because you're not charging, you're getting food for a food pantry, the community's donating, you're building this area. That's how you have to pitch her. I know that doesn't always work, but hopefully that's kind of hit the heart.
Well, we're hoping that it sinks in, you know, that they eventually get, you know, keep pounding on them about it. We have people within that group that want that to happen. So as we get closer to 2017, we'll hopefully have more leverage, and the word about the park will get out. And since we're done with our major construction projects, the park's going to be tore up in the summer and look like a pit rather than a park. So, you know, we knew we had to get over all these construction projects before we were able to actually launch it.
I'd like to know, how do you find information about the events going on, the Starfires games, or any other events going on at Firefield? Because I liked your Facebook page, but I don't see much. It's hard to find information, and like even the reunion.
The biggest problem that we have with women's baseball is there's not a lot of teams, and the teams in Chicago don't have a field that they can play on. So they're subject to the scheduling of the men's leagues that get played on the diamond that they use, and they don't get their schedule out to us. So the girls don't know what their schedule is, so we can't put out a schedule in April and say this is our schedule for the year. And then with the teams in Chicago, if the weather's bad in there, they decide that, you know, it's raining in Chicago, we're not going to Rockford in the sunshine, and our only means is getting it out on the Starfire page on Facebook.
The Starfire's Facebook page?
Yeah.
Okay. So there's no website for Buyer Field, because that might be really helpful, because it's really hard to get info.
Friends of Buyer on Facebook is the page, and it's got a lot of the construction and stuff on there. And then Rock and Starfire on Facebook.
And then one more question, is the ticket booth the only thing that's original?
Yeah, that's a historic thing.
Yeah. So that's original.
That's original, and the theme too, it's original appearance, because the city has it as a historic site. So anything that's done to that has to go through the guy in the city who's responsible for the historic site. Yeah. Well,
I'd like to ask because how many women play the fast pitch softball as such a thing now? It's on ESPN and everything. How many women in general still play hardball? I mean, that's a general question, but
no, that's a very good question, because we have one of the players with us.
To draw teams, you know.
Beth Lang is one of the players on the team. Now, Beth, you want to tell them how you got started?
I'm Beth. I've been playing since I was 6 years old. I played Little League, Boys League for 11 years. And then, of course, I was forced to play softball because there wasn't anything to offer women.
Well, that's my question, yeah.
So now that we're bringing this to the forefront, ever since I got involved with these guys, it's my dream to play baseball. I hope to play for the Major League someday. But I didn't know about the Peaches and stuff that much because I played with boys. I wasn't aware of the Rockford Peaches until I got a little older. And then when these guys started this team up, it was like that was more of a dream than playing for Maple Leafs. Because to me, what those women did for women in general,
that was the
set the tones for everybody. So for me, it's a huge honor to step foot on that field
high school baseball here in Shorewood, Wisconsin, up in Shorewood, and I had girls on my little league team that quite frankly were better than a lot of
them.
And they, when they got to high school, there was no, I had three girls that wanted to play hardball.
I went out for the baseball team in high school, and I got cut because my softball coach paid off the baseball coach to play softball. Oh. So, and I didn't find out until I graduated about that. So, I can handle my own with the guys, but to actually be able to play with women and have that camaraderie, there's a difference.
And it means much more, yeah.
And playing in the footsteps of the Rapid Peaches is huge. I don't think a lot of us women who do play on the team, it doesn't really hit us until we're at game day. Some of us that step on that field, and it's a feeling that you, I can't even express what it looks like. Especially to have Helen, who's original, who's there with us all the time, that's surreal. You don't see the White Sox or the Cubs doing that for little leagues and stuff like that. So to have someone who set this tone for women and to have her support us like she does, it's a little surreal, and it means a lot. And I'm hoping that we can set the tone for women and little girls to come. I know that us girls have talked about how we would like to start putting on clinics for youth girls to get youth girls into baseball and familiar with baseball, and maybe that can set the tone.
Started young and have a path upward.
Yep. It is a hard transition when you're going from softball to baseball. Similar, but it's slightly different going from 94 bases, underhand to overhand. I enjoy it, and a lot of girls who come on to join, who've been playing softball, they're actually taking it on really well. They enjoy it more.
One of the issues with girls playing softball and then playing hardball is they can't play hardball because it interferes with their scholarships in college.
And it's all
that's
like you said.
That's on the verge of changing.
Yeah, we've heard that.
Hear her, so I don't know if you mentioned, like, do you follow baseball for all?
I used to when I was younger. I've kind of gotten away from it because, like I said, it's hard for me to watch professional athletes anymore because I think they get so caught up in their money, and it's hard for me to follow them anymore because, like with us, I like what we do. It's king of skin our games. It doesn't cost a fortune for you to take your family to skin games.
It's really tough. Baseball for All is Dr. Justine Siegel, and he's trying to focus on just women's baseball.
Well, and it's proven, too, that when fast pitch softball kicked in with scholarships, like you said, with the money, participation in Little League for girls went down drastically. Because, like, AAU, they're coming at it when they're 9 years old or 10 years old. So that's just part and parcel of what the whole system is.
I have a comment. Some of these people in here probably played when you see your baseball. Women are more than welcome in that. It's anywhere from 18 to I'm almost 60, so I'll have to be 2 years from now, I'll be able to play in 16 over me. And women are more than welcome in that. I play Madison and Bronx and Bronx.
Here we got time for one more question.
My question is for you. Phil Niekro once said the first woman to play Major League Baseball would be a pitcher. Have you seen or are you the caliber to make it? Do you know, have you seen a player?
I've seen a couple girls, but I don't know names off the top of my head. I do know there's a couple women in like the minor leagues that are either helping with the coaching or whatever. And there's a woman at the end of the team, but down south that has, there's a couple women in the minor leagues, like you know. There was a time where I was at that caliber. I'm working back up to that. Like I said, I stopped playing baseball for a big chunk of my life. I didn't play off in high school. College, I went and played softball. So I wasn't pitching. So I'm rebuilding my pitching, and they can protest my pitching gets better and better every year. I may be getting older and older, but I'm working on my strength. They have a lot of conditioning that we do to build up that momentum. When I was 14, I was pitching 72 miles per hour. So I am able to get back up to that. So it's very possible, and I just think with the right equipment, the right training, it's very possible.
We'd like to thank you for
Thank you.